Hi everyone, I'm Neha. Today I'm going to talk about what happens to poop in the mountains. Have you ever wondered when you go trekking what happens to your poop? We have. In fact, after a lot of experiments at Indiahikes, we have figured out one of the most effective ways of handling poop at high altitudes. We compost it. I'm going to give you a little behind the scenes of the composting process. That way, at the end of this video, you will know exactly what to do when it comes to providing the right composting conditions. I'll sneak in some tips so that you also know what to do to speed up the process of your poop breakdown. So let's get started. To compost poop, all you really need is a hole in the ground. So if you're trekking alone or with a group of two or three trekkers, then carry a shovel. Use it to dig a pit about 1 foot into the ground and then squat over it, do your business, use the mud that you took out when digging to cover it up. This is called the cat pit system and it's a simple enough thing to do when you're trekking with just a few people. But if you're trekking in a group, say 15 to 18 people, that's a lot of poop to handle. You need a bigger system. So at Indiahikes, what we do is we use something called a dry composting toilet pit. It's basically the cat pit system, except it's a lot deeper. That way you don't have to make that many holes and it lasts for a long time. On our treks, we like to keep it at least 4 feet deep. Now, the compost pit is where the decomposition happens. Now, the decomposition is taken care of by the microbes. Microbes are microorganisms that break down organic matter, like poop and pee. Now, like any other living being, they have certain terms and conditions when it comes to composting your poop. They need food, water, air, and shelter. So let me walk you through each of these elements to tell you how exactly you can help out when it comes to providing them. So let's start with food. Now, with food, microbes need a balanced diet of nitrogen and carbon, ideally in the ratio of 1:2. With nitrogen, it's easy enough. Your poop and pee will be rich sources of nitrogen. So once they have that in place, microbes will be able to kickstart decomposition. Next, they need carbon. That has to come from an external source. Now, if you've trekked with Indiahikes, you would have noticed that in our toilet tents, right next to the pit, you will have spotted a sack. A sack which has either sawdust or coco peat, both very good sources of carbon. In fact, if you have coco peat, it's even better because it helps accelerate the decomposition of poop. Now, there's one other element of carbon that comes into the picture, and that's the toilet paper that you'll be using to clean. So after you've cleaned up, you can actually put the toilet paper right into the pit because it's made out of tree pulp, another source of carbon. What we have to be mindful about though is that it shouldn't be bleached or laden with chemicals. That's why at Indiahikes we say no using wet wipes. To know more about why you can't use wet wipes and biodegradable items on trek, watch my videos on them. The next thing microbes need is water. Now, not too much that the microbes drown, but not too less that they get thirsty. And this is where your poop and pee play a role again. Your poop has a little bit of moisture content along with your pee, which will wet the compost pit. This way the pit stays hydrated and that's all you need. That's why it's called a dry compost toilet pit, because you don't have to add extra water to it. Now the last two elements, which are air and shelter, are two things that you don't really have to provide, because the compost system that we have automatically lends itself to provide for these things naturally. Let me tell you how. With air, microbes basically need oxygen because they rely on it to go through aerobic decomposition of the poop. So having a compost pit on the ground allows for natural aeration and allows the compost pit to actually breathe well. The next thing they need is shelter. Now with shelter, you basically need to provide microbes with the right temperature. And that's going to be a hard task. You're in the mountain, it's going to be cold even in the summer treks. So what we do is having a compost pit in the ground actually saves a lot of energy because it's already much warmer under the earth. Along with that, the poop and pee that go into the compost pit are warm. So the microbes have that ambient temperature to do their business. So food, water, air and shelter. These are the four things microbes need. And now you know what happens to your poop when you compost it. If you follow our instructions and our tips, it would take about 6 to 8 months for the poop to completely decompose. In fact, at Indiahikes, after our trek season is over, about 8 months later, we like to go back and check our toilet pits. So you can take our word for it when we say that these dry composting toilet pits are a great way of converting poop into nitrogen-rich manure. If you have any questions, just drop in a comment or email me at neha@indiahikes.com. If you found this video useful, don't forget to like and share. We're on social media, so follow us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. If you found this video useful and you want to stay tuned for more such sustainable trekking tips, then hit the subscribe button.